Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a project for Canvas Core Brands for the Creative Crew for 2016. And I am going to be sharing this little flip book that I made. This was made with a 5x7 inch vertical naked book. In other words, you get the chipboard pieces, they're already cut, they have the tabs on them, they have the holes punched in them, and two rings if you so choose to use them. And then you go from there. I am also going to be using the Gypsy Moments collection. I use the mixed media pad, which is this big pad that comes assorted with corrugated paper. It comes with burlap canvas, the cardstock, the whole schmear. I used extra cardstock pieces in this. I also used the 8x8 pad. I used the printed ATC file folder. I used some little mini clothespins, some of the burlap fringe in the natural color. I used the 7 Gypsies printed file folders. I even used a piece of the packaging. I'll show that to you. The naked book. I used the mini ephemera, some of the tags and ties in the heart, the white heart. And then I used the mini ephemera. So those are kind of some of the things I used, and you'll see them as we go through. I covered the book with the canvas. Now this is included in this mixed media package. And I did the canvas on the front and the canvas on the back. I did have the lace in my stash that I put here on the back. The flower are two pieces of the burlap, and it is the peachy color and the beige color, and I used the Tim Holtz tattered floral. This is my go-to dye. I love this dye. And I cut it out several times and stacked it together and glued them. I used some dyed seam binding, a little Remember the Moments, charm from 7 Gypsies. The Peaceful is from the paper line. The Jute Cording is from Canvas Core, I think, the Home Basics. Okay, and then I just inked around, and the inking I've used is the Distress Ink, the Tim Holtz Distress Ink in Ground Espresso. So let's go to the first page, and this is a different kind of album because it flips vertically instead of open and closed horizontally. So let's flip it. And so the first page here, let's see, I think I'm going to move us in just a little bit closer here. Okay, the first page, I have a book here that I've cut out from the paper pad. And you'll see this if you go through the process. And I've just glued it in two sides. I cut some other books from the paper and stuck them over here at the side. This I show you in the process video is cut out, popped up, and this piece that I cut out is pushed back behind so it looks like it's ripped and torn. And then I have two mats from the paper that I just have stuck back behind here. Then on all of these, I have taken this page from the chipboard or from the paper pack. I love this because if you've got all these words you can use, oh, wonderful. And I took different words and I inked them, and then I just put some mixed media matte gel down and adhered them to the book. Now I've inked around all of the edges of my book. I've covered all of the naked chipboard with solid papers from the 8x8 line, because this is much thinner than what your 12x12 sheets are. Your 12x12 sheets are quite thick cardstock, so I opted for the thinner to cover the pages. Excuse me. So this is the first page, and then we flip the book and we go to the next one. And here I've created what I call a cluster. I love to make these clusters. So I've taken several pieces of the ephemera here. I took one of the little plain white envelopes, bags, little bitty tiny bags. I put a couple of little tags in them. And then, because I was using this new glue, and I explained to you in the process video, I didn't know if I'd like it or not, because you know, sometimes if you use a glue and you happen to stick your finger down, which I often do, you'll get a little shiny spot. Well, that's what I had here, and I just can't handle that. So I just fussy cut this little flower from the paper, inked around the edges, and ran it through my Xyron sticker machine, and put it down, and it covered up all those glue marks. So the thing is, and I say this over and over in all of my videos, because those of you that follow me know that I make mistakes quite often, but there's always a way to cover them up, and most people will never know. And if they're looking that closely at what you've made, hey, they're not your friends. Don't show them anything else you've made. The next page I covered it with this paper, and then I cut a strip that was identical paper. I backed it with a solid cardstock. I fussy cut around it and inked it, and then I glued it down on the three sides. This created my pocket. Here, this is cut from this one page. You've got this little strip here. So I cut one of these, and I used 3D crystal lacquer, 3D crystal lacquer on it, and let it sit. And the key when you're doing this, when you're using a large area or a large amount, let it sit. Put it back, leave it alone, don't touch it till the next day, if at all possible. Then you've got a nice coating that isn't going to bubble, warp, sticky, you know, get fingerprints on, whatever. That's the voice of experience there, touching things too soon. This is just from the mini ATCs, as it was, except that I inked around everything. It slides in the little pocket. This is cut from the paper. This is a little book. I put three of those little words on each one, so they create like a stopper. And this is actually watercolor paper, but it was some scraps I had, and it's a nice, nice weight for pictures. So actually, you could put a picture down here and two more. So you could have 2, 4, 5, 6 on the inside here. Great. And then this just tucks right behind here where we created the little pocket. Another word here. The next page is one of the little pieces from the paper that I just cut out, inked. I kind of roughed it up on the edges and inked it. This is one of the hearts from the Trinkets and Charms from Seven Gypsies. A couple more of the, one more of the file folders. And then this was a scrap that I had, so I just backed it with some solid paper. And then I had this Deco Scallop Edge. This is an EK Success. And I just scalloped along the edge, and then I inked it quite heavily. So you've got some kind of fancy little border there. And these just tuck behind your pocket like that. The next page is, this is the hearts that I showed you here, the plain hearts. I ran it through the sticker maker, the opposite side, so that the top part was sticky. Then I took a piece of the paper, just put it over the top, cut around it, and inked around the edges, put a little bow here out of the jute. And then this is another one of those that from that page that I showed you just a minute ago right here, another one of these. Cut it apart, and I scored along here so it flips back, put another one of the bows to match it, and then I've got this that just tucks in, these little guys. Whoops, I'll have to fix that. There we go. And it's kind of a tight little tuck, but I'd rather have them tight than coming apart. That's upside down. That goes like that, like that. This is the back of the book. Now here's the back. Now what I finally ended up doing, because I didn't like the metal rings, they're just not my thing. So I took this heavy jute from the store, and I had it free so that it moved all over the place. Well, I didn't like that because you couldn't move your pages back and forth very well. So I ended up gluing it down with Beacons 3-in-1. If you ever want anything that's like cement, I use this a lot when I'm using any kind of fabric or twine or anything. The Beacons is wonderful. It's very sticky, very messy, but once it's there and once it's dried, nothing is going anywhere. So I have that down. And like I said, I didn't have quite enough to do the back. So there's two pieces here, and I just covered it up with a strip of lace. And then I inked heavily around the edges again. Now we'll do a flip of the back. Here's the back page. This is another couple of the books that are cut and put on the angle. And then I pop them up. So this creates a great little pocket for my a wonderful for a large square photo and some journaling and some other little ephemera pieces that just tuck right in there. Love this paper line, just love it. And then here's this one. This is one of my favorite ones. I took two pieces. I think I'm gonna put that up so it'll pop up just a little bit more. I took two pieces of the coordinating burlap and just kind of off-centered them. And then I took that piece that I showed you before. I cut the whole strip, and let me untie this. And this is double tied. And then it just flips out. There's no places for photos here. This is just a whatnot. But I just love it. Love how it looks. I'm not going to take the time to tie that back there. And then on this one is another little book, but this one will hold your photos now. And I'll show you in the process video, if you've never done these, how easy it is to make one of these. This is a double a seam binding that goes around the book, so you've got double tie down here. This is just a piece that I cut out from the paper, and I put a little piece of metal behind, a little thin strip, so that I could slide my, I was going to have it slide back and forth, and then I defeated the whole purpose of putting the metal strip because I didn't like how it was moving around, and I glued it solid right to it. But it flips up and down and out and out, and you create this by using just one 12 by 12 sheet of paper. And so you have room for a photo 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, except you need to fold it the right way. And then down. Great. Now what I used on the corners here is this is called the Deco Fan Corner Punch, and this is by Martha Stewart. If you don't have a punch, leave them plain. There's no right, no wrong. You do whatever is pleasing to you. And again, here I have used these little words, and I just inked them really heavy with that ground espresso to kind of give it that grungy look. Then we flip the page, and we have a belly band on the corner or on the angle here. And this is another one of the books with some more of that lace that I used on the back. Then this has a large ATC card in it, which is a great place for a photo or two photos or journaling or whatever you want, plus photos on the outside. Love these ATC cards, these great big, well, I guess these are called file folders. And then here's another one. I just backed it with some solid on the back, because the thing with these, let me see, where's my book? The thing with those, and this is one thing that's super hard, is that, see, you've got these, like I used here, which is just great. But then you've got these great gals on the back side. So it's really hard to cut into this stuff. You just kind of have to close your eyes and just do it to it and pretend there's nothing on the back. But these weren't really appropriate for the book that I was trying to make today. So I just covered them with a solid piece of cardstock and inked all around the edge, and then it just slips in like that. And then this is the inside of the front cover, and I wanted to show you, where is it here? Okay, these are the books from the big 12 by 12 heavy cardstock, and I just inked them and put them down. This creates a nice pocket here for this, the little ATC folder, for another one of those, and this I left the border print around it just to make it a little bit bigger. Backed it solid on the back. Here's another strip. And this is lined. I don't know if you can see that or not in the camera, but this is lined so you can put your journaling on it. And these just tuck in here. But I wanted something a little bit more, and I just love these little tiny clothespins. And I like this. This Gypsy Moments, the art of a moment. But you know where that comes from? That comes from the packaging. It was this little piece that I cut off of the packaging that was in the printed file folders. So I guess what I'm giving you a hint for is utilize everything that you have. I am very careful about the covers that I have on my papers, because I don't know, maybe I'll want to use this on a card or something because it's so heavy, or this, or the packaging in here, or the packaging maybe that you get that is the back part, maybe you'll want to use it. So everything is usable here. Everything is usable. Now we're back to the front of the book, And that's it, everyone. I have never used a naked... Okay, here we go. See, this is the only thing, and I don't know. It's a little more fiddly. And I haven't tied my ribbons there, so it's a little more fiddly with these strings, but I'd rather have it fiddly and have this kind of a look than the metal rings. They just don't do it to me. I forgot to tell you too, this little charm, I used the alcohol inks on it because it was just silver and it just did not work with this. I also sprayed the front of it and the back of it with dazzling diamonds and iridescent gold, but it really doesn't pick up on the canvas. You don't see that effect, but you do see it on this peaceful and on the... You can't pick it up in the camera here, but you see it here. So this is my book. I hope you like it. Be sure and check out the Canvas Course store for all of the items that I've shared with you today. And check out video number 2, which will be the process video showing you how I put this all together. If you aren't a subscriber, I hope you subscribe, like, and comment today. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Have a great crafty day. Bye-bye.